You're watching Electrical Engineering Lectures channel. For more videos, please do like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications.
Hello everyone. In this video, we will be discussing the general concept of magnitude and phase response. In particular, we will be discussing an example of FIR filter, and I will tell you how to draw the magnitude and phase response of an FIR filter. So if you consider any FIR filter having a pulse response h of n, then the frequency response will be given by h of e raised to power j omega, and this DTFT or the frequency response can be split into two components. The first one is the magnitude response. The first one is the magnitude response, and the second one is the phase response. Magnitude response is always even symmetric, and phase response is always odd symmetric if you talk about real h of n. So if the pulse response is real, then the magnitude response will always be even symmetric and phase response will always be odd symmetric. So the first step towards drawing the magnitude and phase response will be to find out the DTFT. And that DTFT can be found by definition or through any other method, but usually we follow by definition. So you can also use the DTFT properties, DTFT transform pairs, and so on. By definition, DTFT is given by the formulation given on this right side. The DTFT h of e raised to power j omega is given by this particular equation, summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity h of n e raised to power minus j omega n. So that is the definition of DTFT. So first of all, we will be finding the DTFT by definition or by using properties or by using transform pairs or any other method. Once we have found out the DTFT, now we will find out the magnitude response separately and the phase response separately. The main point of in the understanding of this point is that we need to find out the DTFT. We need to find out such a mathematical expression that for which phase response and magnitude response can be derived in a relatively easier manner. So the example is a fourth order FIR filter where h of n is equal to 1 for n is equal to 0 to 4. So for fourth order FIR filter means we will have a finite impulse response having only 5 coefficients, and for simplification I have taken only 5 coefficients having their magnitude equal to 1. So this will be the particular impulse response plotted in time domain, and it is a fourth order FIR filter. So the first step will be to finding out the DTFT. So we apply by definition over here, h of e raised to power j omega, it will be given by summation n minus infinity to infinity. I am just writing the original formula first of all, e raised to power minus j omega n. Now for this particular case, the summation will be from n 0 to 4, h of n, which is equal to 1. So I am just skipping that h of n part over here, and I'm just writing e raised to power minus j omega n. Now, in this particular notation, it will be very difficult to find out the magnitude response and phase response. So instead of doing this, what we do, we apply the formula of finite series. So by applying the formula of a finite series, I can write the answer over here as 1 minus e raised to power minus j omega phi divided by 1 minus e raised to power minus j omega. This is the result through finite series, sum of finite series. And now you further expand this particular expression to write it as e raised to power minus j 5 omega by 2 e raised to power j 5 omega by 2 minus e raised to power minus j 5 omega by 2 divided by e raised to power minus j omega by 2, here e raised to power j omega by 2 minus e raised to power minus j omega by 2. Right. So these two, for these two factors, the factors in brackets, you can always convert them by using Euler identity, and the exponentials will be cancelled out to some extent, so that in numerator we will only be having e raised to power minus j 2 omega, And what is happening here? Here we will have sine 5 omega by 2 multiplied by 2 times j divided by sine omega by 2 multiplied by 2 times j. So this 2 times j will also be cancelled out from here, and you are only left with the expression which is e raised to power minus j 2 omega to sine of 5 omega by 2 divided by sine of omega by 2. So this is your DTFT of that particular fourth order FIR filter. Now this formulation is somewhat easier to understand and easier to plot in terms of the magnitude and phase response. So now first of all we find out the magnitude response. For magnitude response, just simply take the magnitude on both sides, and you see the basic rule is that while taking the magnitude response, all the terms which are being multiplied with each other in the formulation, in the expression of DTFT, in the magnitude, all of those terms will also be multiplied. All of those terms will be multiplied. So it means the magnitude of e raised to power minus j2 omega multiplied by magnitude of the second term divided by sine of omega by 2, its magnitude. So you see this particular term, this is basically sinc. This is basically a sinc. So we will see how to plot this particular sinc. But now the main point is that the magnitude of this term will be equal to 1, because it is a general rule of thumb that the magnitude of any complex exponential having any frequency is always equal to 1, right? And what about this expression? Because this is sinc, so first of all we need to plot a sinc, and then we will take the magnitude of that sinc. So all the negative parts will be converted into positive, because sinc is always a real quantity. So that is why there is no concept of taking the absolute value like this, real square plus imaginary square like that. So we only need to convert the negative values into positive values. So first of all, we need to plot the sinc. And to plot accurately any sinc, we need to know the zero crossings. So here I am also telling you the concept of finding out the zero crossings. To find out the zero crossings, the procedure is you put the argument of the sine function from the numerator, which is 5 omega by 2, you put that thing equal to plus minus n pi, right? The argument of the sine function from the numerator, you select that argument and you put equal to plus minus n pi, and find the value of omega. Find omega. So here, if we find omega, we can see from this particular equation, it will be plus minus 2 n pi divided by 5. For n is equal to 0, 1, 2, and so on. So for n integer values, we will have the zero crossing like this. So now we plot sinc over here on the scale of omega. So first of all, I am plotting it in dotted style because I am not taking the absolute value for now. Once I write the zero crossings, then I will take the absolute value. So what will be the zero crossings? First of all, for n is equal to 0, we will have the axis over here, which is corresponding to the peak value. This is the first zero crossing. So for n is equal to 1, it will be 2 pi over 5. So it will be 2 pi divided by 5. Similarly, on the negative side is minus 2 pi over 5. Here, the second zero crossing, it will be 4 pi divided by 5. This is the second zero crossing on the negative side. It is minus 4 pi over 5. The magnitude will be equal to 1, right? So these are the concept of zero crossings, number one. And number two, now we have to take the absolute value. So to take the absolute value, let me now convert the negative values into positive values, and the positive values will remain the same. So it will be like this. It will be converted into positive one, and then this. in this way. So this is the magnitude response of that particular FIR filter, and by looking at this magnitude response, it is very much clear that this filter is a low pass filter, which is allowing the values of the signal at the DC value to pass, and it is stopping all the frequencies. So the main lobe is concentrated around DC. So due to this reason, this is a low pass filter, number one. Now, what about phase response? For phase response, we also invoke the same equation. Let's say we call it this equation number one. So from one again, we take the phase on both sides. So phase of h of e raised to power j omega. Now, here the point is, all those terms which are being multiplied in the expression of DTFT, their phases will be added up. So this is the general rule. All these phases will be added up. And all those terms which are being divided, so the phases of corresponding terms will be subtracted. So that is the basic rule. So here we have got two terms. The first term is the complex exponential. This is the first term, and this is the second term, which is sinc. So phase of the first term will be added in the phase of the second term, right? So the phase of e raised to power minus j 2 omega plus the phase of sinc function, which was this one, sine of phi by 2 divided by sine omega by 2. Now, what is the phase of this complex exponential? So there is another general rule that the phase of any complex exponential is the power of that complex exponential except j, right? So here the power is e raised to minus j 2 omega. So we just discard j, and the remaining term is minus 2 omega. It means the phase will be straight away equal to minus 2 omega. Plus, what about the second term? Now, interesting thing is that the second term is purely real. So intuitively, it is not contributing towards the phase of the system. But there is one point. It is changing sign. It is positive at some values of omega, and it is negative at some other values of omega. So when it is negative, it means it is contributing a minus sign, which is minus 1. So it is basically multiplying the phase by minus 1. And minus 1 can always be written as e raised to power j pi. And e raised to power j pi, which means phase of this particular e raised to power j pi will be what? It will be equal to minus pi or pi, right? So it means whenever the term is negative, it is contributing a phase equal to pi. So, but it is not always negative. It is at some points it is positive also. So we can write this into piecewise function so that the phase corresponding to this term will be zero when this term, which is sine 5 omega by 2 divided by sine omega by 2, if this term is greater than or equal to 0, it means the phase contribution from this term will be 0, and the phase contribution will be equal to pi or minus pi if this term is negative. So we simply write otherwise. So that is the corresponding phase of this particular FIR filter. So we have got two terms, one is minus 2 omega and the other one can be 0 or pi. Now let us plot the phase response of this particular FIR filter on the scale of omega. So first of all, let me plot this term minus 2 omega, which can be plotted by simply using the fact that it is similar to y is equal to mx plus c, and with the slope of minus 2 and y-intercept of 0. So we will plot a straight line like this. I am first plotting it as a dotted line. So here, for example, we have here the value of pi by 2. So at pi by 2, it will be having the value of minus pi. Right? Similarly, at minus pi by 2, it will be having the value of pi. This is only specific to the first term only. But now we have to check the second term also. You see, we have to find out the point where this in second terms becomes negative. So that point was this one, this point, the zero crossings. We have to be very vigilant about the zero crossings. Whenever the frequency crosses 2 pi by 5, so in this particular portion, the sign is negative. Similarly, in this particular portion, the sign is negative. So we have to find out this point, that 2 pi by 5. So we have to look, where is 2 pi by 5? So 2 pi by 5 will be somewhere over here. Here, if you see, this point will be 2 pi by 5. Similarly, here, it is minus 2 pi by 5. So inside this band, the contribution of phase from the second term will be 0, right? So it means we will only be having the actual plot like this. There is no contribution from the second term. But whenever it crosses 2 pi by 5, when it crosses 2 pi by 5, phase of pi will be added up. So it means that this phase will straight away jump. Let us change this point. A bit over here. So there will be phase addition of pi like this, a sudden jump will be there. Similarly, here will also be a sudden jump like this, and after the sudden jump we will again be the phase as here, and when it reaches the point which is next zero crossing was 4 pi by 5. So we will have another jump. Similarly here, it will have another jump at minus 4 pi by 5. So you see, this is the contribution of the second term. And if you complete the cycle of, so it will continue to evolve in both the cases, but we have to, because DTFT is always periodic with period 2 pi, so we only need to plot it from minus pi to pi or from 0 to 2 pi. So from the magnitude response, you can say that this point will be minus pi and this point will be pi. So we are only considering this much band, and similarly here it will be pi here and minus pi over here. So we will be only considering this particular band. So in this way, this phase changes its polarity in a discontinuous way whenever there is a zero crossing. So there is another rule of thumb here for plotting the magnitude and phase response, that whenever the magnitude response shows a zero crossing, there will be a discontinuous change in the phase response. So whenever there is a zero crossing in the magnitude response, phase response will show a discontinuity at the same point. So you see, there are zero crossings at 2 pi by 5, 4 pi by 5, and here the discontinuities are also located at the same points, right? So this is a general procedure to find out the magnitude and phase response in case of FIR systems. Thank you so much for watching.